Yeah, good morning students. So today's class we will be learning about what exactly is hashing. So we have seen already hashing in some of the previous video sessions. We have also uploaded I have uploaded some of the video sessions on hashing. Today is going to be a recap on hashing because hashing is there as part of your third entrance. Okay, now what do we mean exactly by hashing? In case of data structures, we have seen that there are several searching techniques, right? I am just sharing all this here. Searching techniques, we have seen linear search, we have seen binary search. Main drawback of these techniques are as the number of elements increases, the time taken to perform the search will also increase. Okay, now when you have around 5 to 10 numbers, then it is easy for us to manually do the searching and then give the result. When our number of elements becomes more, let us say we have 100 elements, then it is not going to be possible for especially when you go for linear search, it is definitely not going to be possible for us to do the searching. So in order to avoid all these things, we go in for one more technique, which is called as hashing. What is hashing? Hashing is a technique to search any particular element among the several elements. It is also one of the technique for searching the elements, but it minimizes the most important point is it minimizes the number of comparisons that you will have to make when the number of elements are more. But what are the advantages? Hashing is extremely efficient, and the time taken by it to perform the search, it will not depend on the total number of elements. Okay, it completes the search in a constant time. So these are the advantages. Next, let us move on to what exactly is hashing mechanism. So as I said, in hashing an array data structure, we are going to use a data structure which is called as hash table. This hash table is used to store the data items. Okay, based on the hash key value, the data item will be inserted into the hash table. So you have a key, okay, you are going to pass this key into a, give this key as input into a hash function, and then you are, this hash function will generate what is a hash key value. Now this hash key value will get stored into the hash table. This is the entire crux between the hashing mechanism. You have a key, you want to search whether that particular element is there or not. So we are going to pass this element as an input to a hash function. Now when you pass that to a hash function, this hash function is going to generate a hash key value. Now this hash key value gets stored based on the hash key value that is generated. It gets stored in the hash table. Okay, so that is how it gets stored in the hashing. This whole thing is nothing but that is given a key through a hash function. A hash key value is generated and that gets stored in the hash table. This is the mechanism behind what exactly is hashing. Now let us see what are the different types of hash functions that we have. Okay, the first one we have is called as division method. The second one is called as mid square method. The third one is called as folding method. These are the three different methods that you have in order to do the hash. Now let us take each one of them in detail. Okay. Now the first one that we are going to consider is division method. Now this division method, okay, division method is also known as remainder method. Okay, it is the easiest method to compute the hash key. What is the function that we are going to use? We are going to say h of k is equal to k mod m. This is the function. What is m here? M is nothing but the size of the table. In other words, when I say hash key, hash key is equal to, I can put it this way, key value mod the number of slots in the table. This is how we define the hash function in case of division method. So in division method, we have h of k is equal to k mod m. What is m here? M is nothing but the size of the table. Okay. How do you find out the hash key? Hash key is nothing but your h of k. H of k is k mod m. So what we have, k value mod. Mod is nothing but it is going to give you the remainder, right? Key value mod the number of slots in the table. That's how you try to calculate the remainder. Now, let us take some examples of how we can try to do this. I will take some random values. Let us say 26. I'll take 10. I'll take 18. Then let us say 31. Then 54. And then I take 19. These are the set of elements that I have. Now, I'm going to take the hash function as h of, I'll put it in the next line, h of k is equal to k mod 10. So I will take k mod 10, where mod 10 means 10 is what? 10 is nothing but, when I said h of k is k mod m, correct? So I take here h of k is equal to k mod 10. What is 10? 10 is nothing but the number of slots that we have in the hash table. So the hash table is going to consist of 10 slots. Let me put down the hash table like this. 0th slot, the first slot, second slot, third slot, fourth slot, fifth slot, sixth slot, seventh slot, eighth slot, and then the ninth. So these are the slots that we have for in the hash table. Now I have to calculate for each of these numbers. I have to apply it on this particular function and then see where it can be stored inside the hash table. Alright, so now the first element that I am going to take is, I will calculate it here itself. The first element that I am going to take is 26. So I am going to calculate 26 mod 10. Because we have what, h of k is equal to k mod 10. Correct. So what will be my h of k? I have to find out what is going to be my hash key value for this 26. So that I will calculate using k mod 10. So when I take up 26 as my first element, I take the first element, I put it, substitute in this particular function k mod 10, then I will get it as 26 mod 10, which is nothing but, that means when I divide 26 by 10, whatever remainder I get, that is what we are going to calculate. What are we going to get? 26 mod 10, the hash value is 6. This 6 is nothing but, what is 6? 6 is nothing but the hash value. So this hash value is nothing but your h of k. Now I am getting the hash value as 6. So in the 6th position, I am going to store this 26. So that means in a hash table of size 10 positions or 10 slots, where do we store each one of them? That is what we are trying to see. Okay. So when I take this hash key value is generated based on this hash function. Excuse me. Hash function. So what happens? I'll have to substitute each of these elements in this hash function and then I will get a hash key. So when I substitute the first element, 26 mod 10, I get 6. This 6 is nothing but my hash value, or we call it as the hash key value. So in the location 26 mod 10 is 6. So in the 6th location, I try to put or store the value 26. Alright, I hope it's clear. The next value we will take, 70 mod 10. 70 mod 10 is what? That means when I divide 70 by 10, I get remainder as 0. So the hash key value turns out here to be 0. So in the 0th location, I am going to store this 70. Right? So then next what we have 18. So when I try to calculate 18, next value is 18. 18 mod 10, when I divide 18 by 10, I get the remainder as 8. Okay. So in the 8th location, I will store now 18. Then I take up 31. If I do 31 mod 10 is 1. When you divide 31 by 10, we get 1. So in the first location, I will be storing 31. Next number that we have to take is 54. 54 mod 10 is what? 4. So in the fourth location, I would put 54. Next, I am taking up 93. That is my last number. So 93 mod 10 will give me 3. Okay. So in the third location, I will store 93. Now this exactly is nothing but my hash table. So, but I am not able to show the table, hence I am taking it as positions 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Since we have taken k mod 10, our hash table is going to contain 10 positions, 0, starting from 0 up to 9. So, given these numbers, I should find out where can I store these numbers in the hash table. So, based on a hashing function, this is my hashing function, because we said in case of division method, we have the hash function as what? H of k is equal to k mod m. What is m? M is nothing but the size of the table. So when I say how do I calculate hash key, it is nothing but the key value. Key value is nothing but the values that are given to you. Key value mod. Mod means we are going to find out the remainder. Divided by, a remainder, number of slots in the table. That is nothing but your m value. So given this, this is all we try to do. This method you call it as the division method. Let's go for the next method. The next method is called mid square method. Okay. So in this method, how do we do the hashing, or how is the hash key generated? Here the function is defined as, or the hash key function is defined as, h of k is equal to L, small L. Okay. What is L? L, you are going to get L by selecting the digits. Selecting the digits from both ends of k square. Although I put k square, yeah. Both the ends of k square. Hk, what is the hashing function? This is not minus. What is the hashing function? H of k is equal to L. In case of mid square method, hashing function is just L. What is L? L is obtained by selecting the digits from both the ends of k square. What is k square? Whatever number is given to us. So when I do this, first what I should do, for every number k, I should find out what is k square. Now once I find out what is k square, I have to select the digits from both the ends of k square. And then whatever I get will be the hash key value. Okay. Now let us take some examples. Suppose let us say k is, I have taken some examples, k is 3205. Okay, now I have to find out the hash key value of this particular element. What is my function? H of k is equal to L. Wherein I have to select some digits from both the ends of k square. That means first I have to find out what is k square. Correct? That means what is the square of 3205? What is the square of this is what I'll have to find out. Okay, I have calculated this. This will come to 10272025. This is the square of 3205. It's quite a huge number. But anyways, so then once I have found out this square, what is next? I have to write h of k is equal to L, I say. Right? So when I say L is taken by selecting the digits from both the ends. Now, for example, let us say I decide to select the fourth and the fifth digit from both the sides. Okay, from the right side of a square number, let us say this is my right side. If I go from right to left, that's my right side. Fourth and the fifth digit. So this is the first digit. 2 is the second digit. 3, 0 is the third digit. 2 is the fourth digit. 7 is the fifth digit. So what is that I have decided? I have decided to select the fourth and the fifth. Fourth and fifth digit from the right side. This is what I have selected. I have selected my L to be. What is L? L is obtained by selecting the digits from both the ends of K square. So from here also I am selecting the fourth digit from right side. And here from the left side also I am selecting the fourth digit. So that way it's fourth and fifth digit from right side. Whatever way you want, you can tell that. So when I do that, I would get H of K. If I select the fourth and fifth digit, I would get the hash value to be 72. So this is how I calculate in the mid square. That's why we call it as mid square. You take the square of the number, then find out actually the middle two digits. That will become your hash key value. So instead of storing, where do we store 3205? The three hash value for 3205 is just 72. Okay. Now let me take one more number. K is equal to 2432. Okay. So first I have to find out what is K square. So when I find out K square is 5914624. This is K square. Now I'll try to take up the fourth and the fifth digit. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth digit. Or I take it from the, I took it from the right side there. If you want, you can take it from the left side. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then 5. So I can take it as, so my H of K will become 46. Right. So that is called as mid square method. Right. Next we'll go on to one more method, which is called as folding method. In folding method, okay, the key K is partitioned into number of parts, and then we add the parts and ignore the carry. For example, suppose I take a K digit number. Now I am going to divide this into several parts. So I can write this K as D1, D2, D3, D4, which means I can write this K as consisting of a 4 digit number. D1 is the first digit, D2 is the second digit, D3 is the third digit, D4 is the fourth digit. So I have 4 digits here. Now, once I do this, in case of folding method, I said the key K, we are going to partition it into, K is partitioned into number of parts. Okay. And then we add these parts. Okay. And ignore the carry. This is how we calculate the hashing function. K digit number we are taking. First, what we have to do? We have to divide that K into number of parts. Some number is given to me. I am going to divide that number into 4 parts. D1, D2, D3, D4. Because that means that is a 4 digit number. Now, after dividing it, this is a 4 digit number. I have to divide it into number of parts. So, when I want to divide it into number of parts, I will call the first part as K1. Okay. Which I will take it as the first 2 digits form the first part. I will call K2. K2 forms the next part, the third and the fourth digit. So in K, we have 4 digits. What we are supposed to do in folding method? We have to partition it into number of parts. So I will divide this into number of parts. How many parts I am dividing it into? 2 parts. One is K1. Another one is K2. So K1 is going to consist of D1, D2. K2 is going to consist of D3, D4. I have divided it into 2 parts. What should I do next? Add these parts and ignore the carry. Whatever I get after doing this, that is nothing but my hash value. Okay, so let me take an example. I will take h of, again same example, 3205. Now this is a number given to me, that is my k. K is what? 3205. What is the first step that you have to do? Partition it into number of parts. Okay, so how do I partition it? I can partition this into, we have taken it here as k1 as one part and k2 as another part. K1 is the first two digits, k2 is the second two digits. So in that case, if I apply the same thing here, the first part would be 32 plus I am going to get the second part is going to be 05. These are my two parts. We have to add these parts and ignore the k. So when I try to add these parts, 32 plus 5, it becomes 37. So this becomes my hash key value for 3205. Okay. 7184. This is another example. Okay. So this again, if I divide it into two parts, it will become 71 plus 84. If I add these two, I will get 155, correct? If I add these two, I will get 155, but I should ignore the last carry. Ignore the carry. This one is the carry here. So I will take this as answer would be 55 and not 155 because we have to ignore the last carry. Next, let us take h of 1596. Again, I divide it into two parts, 15 plus 96. Okay, 15 plus 96 would be 6 plus 5 is 11, 9 plus 1, 10, 11. 111. Okay, this would be 111, but we have to ignore the last carry, right? So, my answer would be 11. So, that's about the different hashing mechanisms. We have division method, mid square method, and the folding method. Now let us move on to collision. Collision in hashing. What is collision? And then we will see what is called collision resolution techniques. Right? When we say collision, now we took one example in case of division method, right? Wherein I said the hash table contains the hash table contains 10 slots, 0 to 9. Okay, so these are nothing but, let us say, the slots of the hash table. Now collision means what? Two people trying to occupy the same place or the slot, you call it as collision. That's exactly the same meaning in hashing also. In hashing also, we mean collision means two people are trying to contend for the same post or the same place or the slot. You call it as collision. Collision resolution means what? You should try to resolve that collision. How do you break the tie? There is a tie. For, let us say, for second position, there is a tie. Two numbers are to be stored in that position. It is not possible. You can either store one, only one of the numbers can be stored at the slot 2. But if there are two numbers to be stored, if the hash key value turns out to be same for two particular key elements, then how to resolve the collision or how to break the tie basically? That is what you call it as collision resolution techniques. Right? Now, there are two very important resolution techniques here. One is called as separate chaining. You also call them these alternate names. You will all have to be very careful about it. Otherwise, because in the examination, they might ask you with alternate names also. The second method is open addressing, which you also call it as closed hashing. Separate chaining is one method. Open addressing is another. Right? Now, in the first, let us take a separate chain. We'll see what is that. Separate chaining, or we call it as I said, called as open hash. What do we do here? In this case, in this technique, if there is going to be a collision occurring, then we are going to create a linked list to that particular slot. Simple. This technique, as I said, will create a linked list for the slot for which the collision occurs only. Not for every slot. If there are 5 slots, not for every slot the linked list is not going to be created. Linked list is going to be created only for those slots where there is going to be a collision. Okay, that is what you call it as open hashing or separate chaining. Why do you call it a separate chaining? Because wherever there is a collision, it will look as if you have a chain of numbers because you have a linked list created at that location. So that's why you're calling it as separate chaining. Let's take a simple example. Let me take some numbers quickly. 50, 700, 76, 85, 92, 73, 101. Okay. Now, when I take again, I will take this as the hash function. I will take it as h of k is equal to k mod 7. I'll take the 7. So all of us know now how are we going to calculate the hash key value. Okay, we are given this function h of k is equal to k key mod 7. So that means for every number here, we are going to take each of these numbers, divide it by 7, find out what is the remainder because we have mod here, and then place it in the hash table. How many locations hash table will have? It will have 7 locations. Because you have given key mod 7. First, let me put down these, make some space. Yeah. So, let me put down the slots of hash table. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6, that's all. Because key mod 7 means hash table size is 7. So, you will have 0 to 6 slots. Right? Okay. Now, let us see what happens. We will take each of these numbers one by one. First number is 50. Okay. So first I will find out what is 50 mod 7. What is 50 mod 7? 50 mod 7 is 1. In the first location, so I will go and store this 50. Right? Next I have 700. What is 700 mod 7? 700 mod 7 is 0. When you divide 700 by 7, remainder is 0, right? So in the 0th location, I'll go and store 700. Next number is 76. 76 mod 7 is again 76 mod 7 is how much? 6. Right? So in the 6th location, you will be placing 76. Next is 85. 85 mod 7. 85 mod 7 is what? 1. Okay, 87 mod 7 is 1. So, in the first location, now you observe. In the first location, we already have 50 stored in the first location. Then, 85 mod 7 is also 1. That means, you should also store 85 in the same location. Correct. This is where now we say that a collision has happened. Because you have 50 as well as 85. Both are in the same, going to occupy the same slot, which is 1. So, that is a collision. How to resolve this collision? As I said, wherever or whichever slot there is going to be a collision, for that slot alone, we are going to create a linked list. That means this slot 1 is already occupied by 50. Next. I will create a linked list here. Let me put that as an arrow. Create a linked list there and then store in the first node of the linked list. I am going to store this 85. That is how I try to resolve the collision. Next number is 92. Let me calculate what is 92 mod 7. 92 mod 7 is 1 again. So 92 mod 7 is also 1. So see, you are observing 50 is already there in the slot 1. We created a linked list because 85 was also colliding at the slot 1. So the first node of the linked list contains 85. We now put one more node. The second node will now contain 92. All right. So that is how we try to resolve the collision. Next number is 73. Okay, let us see. 73 mod 7. 73 mod 7 is what? 3, right? So the third location is empty. So you don't have an issue. So 73 will come and store there. Wherever there is a slot, whichever slot has a collision, only that slot you are going to create a linked list and store the numbers. Other slots, if there is no collision, then we need not bother at all. The last number is 101. Let us try what comes for that. So 101 mod 7. 101 mod 7 will give me what? 3. Okay. So 3 here, if you observe, 73 is already stored in 3. Now this 101 is also going to get stored at 3. Right? So I have to create a linked list at this position. And in the first node, I will store 101. That's because 73 is already stored in the slot 3, position 3. This is how we try to resolve the collision by separate chaining method, or we call it as open hashing method. Okay. I hope it is clear to all of you. We will take one more example. Let me take one more example. 20, 11, 23, 85, 83, 56, 33, 9, 16, 10. Okay. Let me consider M as 10. 20, 11, 23, 85, 83, 86, 33, 9, 16, and 10. Yes. So your H of K is going to be K mod 10, which means that there is going to be 10 slots in your hash table. I'll put on the slots 0 to 9. Okay. Right. Now, let us calculate what is K mod 10. Let me take the first value, 20. 20 mod 10 is 2. So in the, I'm sorry, 20 mod 10 is 0. So in the 0th location, you are going to have 20. There are no issues there, no collisions. Next. Next is 11 mod 10. 11 mod 10 is 1. So in the first location, we put this 11. Next is 23. 23 mod 10 is 3. So in the third location, we put 23. Next is 85. 85 mod 10 is going to be, I made a mistake. 85 mod 10 is going to be 5. So in the fifth location, we put 85. Next we have 83, right? So 83 mod 10 would become 3. So in the third location, we already have a number in the third location. 83 mod 10. 23 mod 10, we already have the number 23 in that slot. So now we have 83 mod 10, which is also 3. So we create a linked list and put 83 there. So that's how we try to resolve that collision. Next, we were, where were we? 56. 56 mod 10 is going to give you 6. So in the 6th location, we write 56. Next, we have 33 mod 10, which is again 3. Okay. So create a, we have already created a linked list. One more node we create and put 33 there. Because all 23, 83, 33, all are for the slot 3. There is collision. That's wherever there is collision, only there we are going to create a linked list, not otherwise. 9 mod 10 is going to be 9. The 9th slot is anyways free, so place the 9 there. And then we have 10. 10 mod 10 is again 0. Now, 0th location is already occupied by 20. So create a linked list at that position. And then in the first node, we place this 10 because both are contending for the 0th slot. Right? So this is what you call it as, separate chaining or open hashing. Right? So I think this finishes your revision on this hashing. Maybe one more session if we can have some time, then later I'll take up one more session and then show you what is, we'll take examples on closed hashing and try to do that in the next session if time permits. All right, for this session, I think I'll end this session with this. And see you all in the next session. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, no, that's not. Yeah, so then I just have that one.